Good morning, community. Welcome to the virtual worship service. If you're tuning in with us for the very first time, or you've been visiting for a while, you are so welcome. Give us a WhatsApp, send us an email. We'd love to invite you, include you, welcome you into our faith community. My name is Anandie, and welcome in my living room. And thank you for inviting me this morning, this afternoon, this evening, later in the week, into your living room. We're going to start the service with a moment of silence. We do this every week as a reminder and becoming aware that we are gathered together, but that we're also gathered in God's name, and that we don't have to invite God in, that He is already present there where you are. So let's become aware of that. And while you take a moment of silence, take the candle and the matches that we use every week and light it as a symbol, as a reminder that God is there with you. God is in your life, whether we feel like that or not, whether we have a testimony to give or not, God is there. Let's take a moment of silence and light the candle. Are you tired? Are you worn out? Are you burnt out on religion? Come, just as you are. Let's listen to the song, Come. Now is the time to worship.
Time to worship. Come, now is the time to give your heart. Come, just as you are to worship. Come, just as you are. Before
greeted this morning in the name of the God who is our parent, our mother, our father, in the name of Jesus Christ, who is our friend, our redeemer, our savior, our Lord, in the name of the Holy Spirit, who is our comforter and sustainer. Glory to the triune God, in whose name we gather. Peace be with you. Let's turn to our households. Let's greet each other with a hand, shake each other's hands, everyone sitting there with you. Look each other in the eye and say, peace be with you. If you're tuning in our live stream, you can just type in the live chat, peace be with you. For our family moment this week, I'm going to ask you again as a household to turn to each other and talk to each other. So this is our favorite home moment. We don't have Sunday school or material that I send to you at the moment to do with your children or your teenagers, but I want to encourage you to once a week watch, tune in, discuss the worship service together, and in each one there will be something that I ask you to turn to each other and share with each other. So try and do this, try and get into a rhythm of Sundays, our worship services, gather them together, shake each other's hands, light the candles, and do this discussion and listen to the sermon as well. Last week I asked you to share with each other what was good, what was bad during this lockdown time, just to listen to each other's heart. This week, very similar but a different question. I'm asking you, what makes you tired, okay? And what gives you energy? So think back during this lockdown time. Again, be honest with each other. Just share it. Don't preach to each other. Don't try to fix anything. Just listen. What is giving you energy and what is taking your energy away? What is making you tired? And what energizes you during this time? You can pause the video and talk about that. And again, this is not just if you have children or teenagers. Adult households can also do this. Our scripture reading for today is from the Gospel of Matthew. So you can open up with me at Matthew 11. We're going to read from verse 28. Matthew 11, verse 28. But before we read together, let's pray together. In times of sorrow, we listen to your word. In times of joy, we listen to your word. Open your word, Lord, for our hearts are ready to receive. Amen. Usually this text has words that you know, and you should know this text actually quite well. Come to me, all who are weary and burdened. I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you. Learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy, and my burden is light. A yoke is something that was used for ox, for two oxen at least, usually, which was a wooden thing that was on their shoulders, on their neck, and they pulled these two together, these two oxen, and they had to work as a team. Then obviously they were actually forced to work together. They couldn't just do what they wanted to, so someone, the farmer, would then manage them into a direction in a way that he would want to use them. The yoke can also refer to the law. Apparently, in Jewish tradition and literature, people would have known when they heard Jesus talk about this, that it could refer to the law. During this time that Jesus speaks to this group of people, just before this, he tells them that you didn't really know what to do with me or John. You weren't excited or sad. You thought I was a drunkard because I would eat with sinners and tax collectors. And John wanted you to repent, but you didn't get that either. So now he's talking to them. And he realizes something, and he speaks actually to something very to their heart. So the law, which was supposed to be like a code for the road, a way that we would be helped to know which way to go ethically and what would God's guidelines be for our lives, became something very hard and burdened to carry for the Jewish group he's speaking to. The Pharisees made it very hard, very strict, kind of missing the point of what the intention was with the law, why God gave it to them. Something that was supposed to be inscribed in their hearts and remind them to live differently than other nations, to remind them who they are and therefore they have to live a certain way, became something like a tick list and extremely hard and weighty to carry. I'm going to read you the Message translation. I'm going to read it quite slow. And I want to invite you to try and put yourself in the shoes of the first readers or hearers that heard this text. But also try and put yourself here in the text. What is it that's heavy for you? Is it also something maybe of religion? And what does God tell you today? What is Jesus inviting you to? Are you tired? Worn out? Burned out on religion? Come to me, says Jesus. Get away with me and you'll recover your life. I'll show you how to take a real rest. Walk with me and work with me. Watch how I do it. Learn the unforced rhythms of grace. I won't lay anything heavy or ill-fitting on you. Keep company with me and you'll learn to live freely and lightly. I wonder this morning what the Jewish group that heard this thought, experienced, if they had a sense of relief, oh, this is what it's supposed to be like. I wonder if you have a moment like this morning. This phrase, burnt out on religion. Are you maybe trying so hard that doing the right thing, the things on your list that you think you need to do to have a good relationship with God, the things on your list that you might think you need to do to be saved, the things that other Christians might pressure you, the things we maybe never talk about that things are difficult sometimes, or that we maybe don't talk about grace enough. Can you also maybe say, that's not what it's all about? Jesus comes and he tells this Jewish group that my yoke, my law, my way of living, my rhythms is softer than the pressure what the Pharisees are putting on you with all the don'ts. Don't do this, don't do that, don't do this, don't do that. You need to do this, you have to do this, you should be this way. Now you see, Jesus isn't saying in this text that we can go about doing freely whatever we want. It's interesting for me that he's still talking about a yoke, but a totally different way. And the way that Eugene Peterson paraphrases this helps me to understand something maybe of the meaning of this text. I wonder if you and I could stop putting so much pressure on ourselves about what the ideal Christian is supposed to be, look like, speak like, do, but that we would rather take this yoke up. A discipleship, a journey with Christ. And we've talked about this weeks, maybe when we just started with lockdown, about that discipleship is costly. Maybe you remember that. So I'm not trying to say it's not, because it is. We've discussed this. And if you've missed it, go and check it on our YouTube channel. But the difference here is that even though discipleship is costly and it asks everything from us, it's a different yoke. It's not one where we're supposed to be worn out. It's one where Christ walks with us. It's one where Christ directs us. It's one where he teaches us what real rest is. Some people write about this text and talk about when we read in the creation stories in Genesis about how God created and then God rest. I try and say maybe it's something going off back to that way, how it was intended that we should also rest, that God created rest. And this text and the passages just before this, it talks about wisdom. And I want to invite you to go on a journey of discernment with me. What does it look like to walk with Christ in the midst of costly discipleship? How is his yoke, his way, softer, kinder than what the Pharisees expected in terms of religion? How can you be more softer towards yourself? I'd like to end reading this text again, and I'd like to invite you to find within the passage where you can be softer with yourself and other people as well when it comes to our faith and what we believe and all the things that everyone thinks we should do or not do. It is all about grace. Christ has already done everything. There's nothing more that you can do except walk with Christ and allow him to teach you his ways. That's his invitation. You are invited to walk with Christ and let him direct you. Are you tired, worn out, burned out on religion? Come to me, says Jesus. Get away with me and you'll recover your life. I'll show you how to take a real rest. Walk with me and work with me. Watch how I do it. Learn the unforced rhythms of grace. I won't lay anything heavy or ill-fitting on you. Keep company with me, says Jesus, and you'll learn to live freely and lightly. Let's pray together. Dear Lord, thank you that we can read a text like this in a time where we feel many, many burdens in our lives. Where these burdens sometimes even include how we think about faith and our relationship with you. Thank you for reminding us this morning that you've done it all. That your grace is enough and that you invite us to walk with you. Here we are, Lord. We've laid down our lives before and we've maybe done it many times, but this morning, again, we want to take up your yoke, your way of living, the way you intend the law and direction. We want to place down everything about what we think life should be. And we want to take up and say, teach us about life and your rhythms. In Christ Jesus' name alone. Amen. Our announcements for this week. The details for the offerings are on the screen. And we'd like to thank you for April, March, June, going for July, that we've been having virtual worship services and you've been not only engaged in the services and everything that we've been doing, but you've also continued with your offerings and we thank you for that. Thank you for all the help that you've been giving during this time, dropping off food, people that have packed food, thank you. We would also like to announce officially that there will be no church services in the church building for July. We will reevaluate at the end of July in terms of what will be happening in August. So for now, we will continue with our virtual worship services. Please tune in. Don't stay away from the gatherings, even if it's virtual. It's as much a worship service in a gathering as it would be in body in the church building. Please stay in contact with me and with each other. Let's be the body of Christ and the fellowship, even when we can't gather in the church building. We're doing this for different reasons that we're not going to gather in July. It seems that the numbers are spiking in Gauteng. The hospitals are getting a lot of people that are sick, and there are a lot of implications. Say, for instance, if someone would test positive in one of the church services, everyone else would have to be contacted. People need to self-isolate then, and we want to go about this in an ethical way, especially during this time when it's becoming more numbers and more positive cases. If you do test positive, please let me know. We'd love to pray for you. We'd love to know how you're doing. Share that with us. Arnie and I, we had to go in self-isolation for some time. Neither him or I tested positive, but someone that he was in very close contact with did. I know self-isolation is not very easy at the moment. And I'd love to support you if that's something that you would be going through. And then, we hope that you have a wonderful week. After the blessing, there's another song, Thy Word is a Lamp Unto My Feet. Listen to it. Talks about a direction in our lives, and it fits with some of the things we talked about during the sermon. Receive the blessing of the Lord. All who are weary and heavy laden, the Lord will bless you and keep you. The Lord will make his face shine upon you, and he will be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace and rest. Amen.
Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. When I feel afraid, think I've lost my way.